here. Mike Shoesmith is here. He is my guest this afternoon in this segment and a co-host, longtime Canadian correspondent to Freedom Friday. Mike, it's good to have you with us. So I'm understanding that you also have a story you want to bring to us concerning the building of the pyramids that have long been speculated by a sizable segment of speculators that perhaps it was done with alien technology. But you're telling us that there's some scientific proof that it's otherwise. Talk to us about that.
Well, this comes to us from the our friends at Coast to Coast AM. You know, they are our friends. We do love those people. This is coming from their blog. Archaeologists in Egypt may have solved one of history's most contentious debates, Carl, how the Great Pyramid of Giza was built, to be detailed on a forthcoming documentary on British television. A team of researchers say that a newly discovered piece of papyrus contains the answer to the long-standing mystery. The ancient scroll was purportedly written in an official, by an official in charge of overseeing the construction of the legendary monument and details the process by which it was accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
So there we go. It's like the Dead Sea Scrolls of the Giza Pyramid.
Okay, so how was it accomplished?
Well, according to the account, workers managed to transport the massive blocks of limestone used to build the pyramid by shipping them along the man-made waterways that connected the Nile River to the construction site. What seems to strengthen the case, Carl, is that indeed this is how the materials were brought to the base of the pyramid, are a pair of additional discoveries made by archaeologists. One researcher believes that he has found evidence for the artificial waterway that has since been buried by desert sand, while another investigator has reassembled a ceremonial boat that appears to match the one used by workers to transport the limestone for the pyramids. Here's the takeaway point here, Carl.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately for the alien hunters, the first-hand insight from the proverbial pyramid foreman contains nary a word about any alien helping with the project, nor anything particularly mystical about the process.
Yeah.
So you know, many people speculate that these pyramids and all of this stuff was built over the course of 400 years by, you know, those Hebrew slaves that used to live there in Goshen there. Remember those guys?
Yeah, I remember those.
I mean, my opinion is, you know, if we look at, you know, the United States has been around for 270 years. Look at what we've done. I don't include myself in that. I'm not an American. But look at what, I guess, you know, Canada has sort of piggybacked on your technological advances down there. Look at what we've done in 270 years.
I was going to say, I've been in Toronto, and the city of Toronto far outweighs the marvels of the pyramids. I mean skyscrapers, high-rises,
yeah, sure.
Millions of people, interstate highways, infrastructure, underground buses, railways, above ground railways. I mean, you know, far exceeds what the pyramids have done. And Canada is doesn't have the same age the United States does.
No, Canada's. We still have the Queen.
We're still
a British colony. We've been around a lot longer than you guys.
Well, yeah. But you guys, But the point is Toronto is not as old as some of the big major cities of the United States, right?
Right, it's not. But research on how the railroad crossed from east to west. Rather, it met somewhere in Utah, I think. I think the Chinese built it from the west to the east, and the free black men built it, and the Irish, they built it from the east to the west.
Right.
And if you look at documentaries, how that was all done, and over the course of just a few decades.
Right.
I mean, that is just shocking.
Right.
But then we look at how in 400 years, could not they have used boats to transport these giant blocks from the lime quarry to the construction site using boats. It looks like that's what happened.
Sure.
And in my opinion, Carl, it was the Hebrew slaves that did it, in my opinion.
Yeah, and other slaves from other nations that they conquered. I mean, Egypt was the empire of the world. And so you had 400 years. People think about it. The United States hasn't even been around 300 years. And yet look at what we've created in less than 300 years. Dozens and dozens and dozens of megacities, super cities, skyscrapers, interstate highways. I mean, we've gone to the moon. We fly through the air. We've got airports. And I mean, I could go on and on. And people say, yeah, but the technology is different. Well, the pyramids reflect that. You got a handful of pyramids in 400 years. I mean, we've got pyramids in Las Vegas, brother. There are hotels that look like pyramids. I mean, yes.
Hey, I was just in Vegas yesterday, in fact, and I did see that pyramid. And going through Las Vegas, you see a spectacular city that was built in a desert, hundreds of miles from any civilized area. Granted, built by the mafia, but still, I mean, Las Vegas is a spectacular testimony to what people can do over the course of a couple of decades. And if you give you know, a bunch of Hebrew slaves 400 years, they will build you a pyramid now.
Yes, I'm telling you, hundreds of thousands of those slaves over 400 years. I mean, when Moses left, the Bible tells us, when you do all the math there were more than 1 million Hebrews alone that left at the end of the 400 years. So that means over at the end of the 400, so over the 400, there were several millions of Hebrews that were born and raised and died in there, and hundreds of thousands for 400 years that worked on a handful of pyramids. Yeah, they got it done with the technology they had.
Right, and you know, we can even break it down to a more micro level. Take a look at whatever you're driving. I mean, the technology involved in, say, an 18-wheeler, for example, or a Mercedes-Benz or whatever, is just amazing, the technology, the millions of parts moving, hundreds of thousands of parts moving together in unison, synchronicity. I mean, it's an amazing thing, what the evolution of vehicles over the last 100 years. I mean, give them 400 years, yeah, they'll throw up a pyramid, no problem.
Yeah, well, you know, so you're saying if you want a pyramid built in Egypt, give them 400 years and hundreds of thousands of Hebrews, and they'll build you a pyramid. And we're saying if you want a hotel that looks like a pyramid built in Las Vegas, give us some Italian mafia dudes, and we'll build you one in a decade.
Or if you want to build a wall along the Mexican border, just put a wall tariff on avocados coming out of Mexico, and I guarantee the Mexican president will write a check the next day. Guaranteed.
Yeah.
That wall is going to get built, and the Mexican people will pay for
it. I'm telling you, I don't know if you heard the top of the hour, but I was just saying before I brought Dr. Michael Brown on, and by the way, he's a great friend and a great guest. But before I brought him on, I said, you know, that's the only thing that this Republican Congress has been able to accomplish is to get a Republican president investigated for a false charge. That's it. They can't build a wall. They can't deal with Obamacare. They can't lower taxes, although they've been campaigning on it for 8 years. They can't do any of that, but they can get the president investigated. They can do that.
Is it too late to say impeach Obama? Is it too late to say that?
Yeah.
Too late? Okay, sorry. Well, listen, I see my time is up. I love you guys, and hopefully I will see you guys next week. How's that sound?
That sounds great. Thanks, Mike. We got to get out of here.